us, Jake Allen is just 24. Very important to his team. 8 wins and 11 starts. His team is third in the league in defense. Antti Raanta is just 25, has not started a game since the World Series. Fourth start of the year, his last was a 3-2 loss in St. Louis. And I don't want to predict anything, but Steve Ott, David Backes are starting for St. Louis. Daniel Carcillo and Andrew Shaw and Brian Bickle for Chicago. I'm not thinking scraps, but I'm thinking guys that don't get along well, and we're seeing that with Shaw and with Ott. And we have a legal face-off, and the game is underway. A
couple of Rams right there to take that face-off. Seeing that type of play tonight.
To the back, it comes for the first shot. That one was tipped aside, and then Backes went for it and was checked off the play by Duncan Keith. And then on to the back, Shattenkirk. Fed it right back across again, and Carl Gunnarsson with a shot that is held by Raanta, and there's a little more after the whistle.
Yeah, Shaw and Ott again.
Together. No surprise there. Pumped right back to the point. Rolled around behind, and it's whipped on through to be taken around to the outside by Kane. Took a swat there, and a second one. Kane got it over to Seabrook, and Seabrook waits. And blasts one, and that one turned aside by a stick in front. Forced around. Gotten eventually by Kane, on back for a shot by Seabrook that was blocked away by Allen and then trickled on back to center.
Kill off 15, 20 seconds.
Rifled on across, came to Steen, faked the drive, gave it on back once more. Crowd gathers in front. Big drive by Steen, and that one is deflected up high, and everyone looking for it. Taken along now by Hossa, and will be skated down at center and carried back on by Taves. Taves looking and shooting, it's struck high in the air by Allen, and poked aside where the Blues can take over and start out offensively. Held to the outside and led back to Oshie again. Hands back across Petrangelo with a shot. Rang off the pipe and it's squipped on back. Two posters, no goals. Petrangelo forced it through. Here's Saad and that pass went by him. Allen has to step out, but could he handle it in the trapezoid?
Rifled one off the post. We saw Ian Cole earlier in transition. This is more of a set situation and it just goes off the right post.
Boy, they've had a couple of good looks from the back end. And how about the play by Petrangelo? Watch this play here as the Blackhawks look like they're going to have a breakaway. The diving play by Petrangelo deflects the pass from Hossa to Saad, but not create that breakaway chance.
Tarasenko laid back up the wing for control, and a shot ricocheted off Raanta there. Can be controlled around and led back to the point. Shattenkirk sped it back across. Gunnarsson a shot that goes wide. Laterra played one to the front, but it's grabbed off by Hjalmarsson. Led to the back again for Shattenkirk. Plays it on now for Tarasenko. Shattenkirk once more. Loads the gun and lets it go, and a save, and then a scramble around behind. As tied up on the play by Laterra for a moment was Raanta. Gets back to make this block. Laterra has it around behind. Led it to the back to Gunnarsson. Hands it back over for Shattenkirk, and a misfire, or at least a mishandle, and so they must drop back to center. Thrown across by Steen, right around in front, poked off the stick, and it came onto the back. Almost escaped was Tarasenko, but a good job done to the Blackhawks there, and then Saad steers it on, carried by Krueger.
Watch this area of the ice. Is going to enter the zone. You have people going to the net. The opportunity and the defensive play by Jonathan Toews. Look at five Blackhawk players back in their own zone. The stick by Brandon Saad, and all of a sudden it's a two-on-one. Krueger, right past Allen.
Now there's the adjustment. They wanted to be tighter on the St. Louis Blues point man. Brandon Saad bought in after the great defensive play by Toews, and what a great utilization of the two-on-one.
Carcillo and back in, and along to get it is Tickle. The big man dips his shoulder and goes behind. Really run off by Backes. Loose puck taken by Shaw. Backes right back and steps into him with some authority. Healing off of that is Shaw. Tried to roll it along, but the referee's checking got in the way. Turned along by Bickle in front of Shaw. And that had to be turned aside by Allen. But cut and started out by Versteen. As Hossa up one side, hands on to Kane. And Kane fed to Hossa. Hossa shot! Grab by Allen, who has been very strong in goal. A little surliness near the front of the net after the whistle. Failed, and so after this one is Carcillo. Carcillo around behind, shoved off there by Gunnarsson. Twists a little bit further and sent it on for Rundblad, who guided it on to Shaw. It's Shaw turning, on back for another shot by Rundblad, and that one hopped wide. Poked back along by Carcillo, who was run into effectively there by Chris Porter. And a chance here, and so coming way out is Rondon and sweeping away. He tumbles to the ice. It's carried back in on an offside, and play is stopped. For the Blues right now, jammed on for the point, but Kane stepped there, though he didn't take over.
That's a penalty. He's going to get one. Rooney just made the call.
Delayed call against the Blackhawks. Taking it along now as Ian Cole dropped it behind for Ott. Ott touched it along. Butler holds there. Butler pushed it on back for Ott. Flexed it from Berman across. They score! Ian Cole!
What a beautiful play. And you called it, Doc. The Blues had something going. It all started because of the giveaway by Brent Seabrook. The failed clear by Patrick Kane. He was going to get a penalty for breaking his stick and throwing it at the puck carrier. And then the Blues got the extra attacker and were able to set this puck up. Just great passing. Ott throws it out in front of the net and a quick little shovel pass there from Berglund to Ian Cole, the defenseman who had come in backdoor.
And that's more of the type of hockey that he wants. Big bodies getting to the front of the net. And this is where the problems all started. Kane's stick breaks, turnover, penalty's going to happen. You see Rooney puts his arm up, then they can engage the cycle and get the bigger bodies going to work.
The one thing I'd like to see is that with that extra attacker, the Blues scored with the extra attacker. They scored, so that negates the penalty to Kane. If you think about it, if that happens, if the Blackhawks were shorthanded there and they took a delayed penalty,
here's Schwartz playing one ahead that's nicely played on now for Oshie. Oshie a shot, save made, rebound, and checked off while Stastny sent on to the back now. Back, a shot, and another try, and it's nice loose at the front of the net and a scramble there, walking away with it. Kruger after the whistle. He's dealt it on to Kane, then on to the back to Seabrook. Seabrook for Kane once more on this power play. Back in deep to Taves. Taves steps toward the front, trying to triple it through. Back step by Verstappen, and a save made by Allen. And then a rocket from Keith was wide. Power play for the Blackhawks. Marching back in is Kane. Kane with a shot. Ricocheted and appeared off the outside of the cage. Maybe it was the stick I heard of Allen. It comes to Keith. And Keith faked and gave it back over to Kane. Worked back in deep to Taves. Taves works around the outside now and looks toward Keith and gives it to him. Across one-time shot, ricocheted off the pipe from the stick of Seabrook.
That hit the netting. That's why the whistle went. This net down here is getting a workout. It's the third piece of iron in this game, two from the Blues and that one from Seabrook.
Patrick Kane, his penalty time is up now. Thrown across to Keith, and his shot was steered wide by the reach of Ott. And then a hit! Versteeg has broken the tie!
Well, that was the combination, but just reversed. Versteeg gave it to Taves. Opportunity, and then Taves gets this puck to Chris Versteeg, and all in one motion. His stick is on the ice. It's in a shooting position. No chance for Allen.
Eddie, I have to tell you, watching Chicago in practice this morning, Kevin Dineen, before they got into their whole practice, was working with a power play. That was one of the options they were working on. And he's telling Jonathan Taves and Chris Versteeg on the bench, way to go. They ran through six different options on their power play. That was one of them.
Out for the St. Louis Blues and Patrick Sharp out for the Blackhawks right now.
This is Taves with a shot into the catching glove of Allen. Away by Rundblad so that the Blackhawks can accelerate back out. Brad Richards with a pass that is carried on by Versteeg. That one across the cage.
Well, you mentioned mentioned Christopher Stieg a little bit earlier, Doc. The exit out of the zone. Kane to Richards to Versteeg. Lots of time there. But what a pass there from Versteeg to Patrick Kane going far side on Jake Allen.
Basketball players have their spot. I really think a lot of times this is Patrick Kane's spot. He gets it, he's going long side,
and he just whips that by Jake Allen.
It is Allen out to play this one and spin it around behind, and that for a play by Roosevelt. Scaled it ahead for Hulsa. Tapped on for Saad. Good check on him. Two goals in less than 2 minutes' time. Brought back ahead for a shot that is sealed up by Allen from Nordstrom.
Over to Patrick Kane. Now you see the puck on edge. I want everybody to keep an eye on the stick blade of Christopher Stieg to settle this down. This is the first part of this. He settles it down, turns it over, cuffs it. Now watch this pass. It goes right over the stick of Alex Steen, right on the tape of Patrick Kane. It goes right by Jake Allen. A little bit of a screen there by Barrett Jackman.
Not about it. It was a healthy scratch in the playoffs. And what a move. Petrangelo wrapped around, but sliding across was Roosevelt.
Looks like he's in much better condition now and playing with a lot of confidence and got jumped in his step. And he's one of those confident offensive players.
Here's Kane.
Well, Christopher Stieg's going to get his third point in a matter of about 3.5 minutes. Just puts this puck into the middle of the ice, and then Patrick Kane skates left, slides it under the legs of Jake Allen, and the Blackhawks with a 4-1 lead.
It's almost not fair, the skill level of Patrick Kane, the composure with the puck, and the finishing ability. That's not easy to pull off against a rock-solid defenseman like Barrett Jackman. And there's a little bit of hockey strength, too, for Patrick Kane on that finish.
Yeah, there was going to be a penalty there on Jackman.
There's your rule, Eddie.
Yeah. The look from Patrick Kane on the left and Christopher Stieg on the right.
Far.
Well, once Patrick Kane's able to get inside position, he leans in, gets two hands on the stick. Allen is down early.
Control, and there was school the next day, sometimes as well. Along to take this now, and pivot is Saad. Wanted to trickle it through, and a wheeling shot on the backhand by Hossa was wide. Now Saad dropping it on, taken by Taves. Blackhawks captain flipped it on now to Saad. Saad set it up for Hossa's shot that's blocked. To the point it comes for a shot that is blocked away.
This one's not an easy place to play anymore either, Doc.
No, neither one of those places. Yeah.
Nicely stopped in front off of Roosevelt, and Rock has sealed it up, and there's a battle still, but has the puck. An unofficial one I think I may have noticed in the Guide and Record Book, which is annually published by the NHL. Ahead with this now comes Brad Richards, and Richards with an angle and making the stop was Allen.
Tonight, TJ Oshie real quiet offensively, but doing an outstanding job defensively with a couple of those shot blocks.
That's Nordstrom with a couple of smart moves there, brought back in by Keith. Across for Kane, and getting a piece of it was Allen. Crowd buzzing about that as it's filtered through now to the turning Schwartz, led onto the back for a hurry shot into the catching glove of Ranta by Berglund. 5:44 to go here in the third period, regulation time, and it's the Blackhawks by 3. Seabrook had prevailed.
I don't believe that Doug Armstrong is done.
Carcillo save, and then Carcillo bumped into Allen, and we see no arms up, and so play is simply stopped as they check on the condition of the goalkeeper.
Doug Armstrong, the general manager, I don't think he's done acquiring and making moves moving forward, but here's that chance for Danny Carcillo, and Carcillo got hit and then bumped into the goaltender Jake Allen. Alex Petrangelo with a little bit of a nudge.
Watch Petrangelo's stick. That's his stick into the hip of Jake Allen. New goalie coach here, Jimmy Waite. Eddie Bent down in Rockford.
Going to get a penalty behind the play here, it seems.
Look out. Castillo and Jackman.
Yeah, Jackman was looking for Roosevelt, and Tarasenko took a shot right in front of the, right inside the blue line of the Blues. And Jackman was making a skate over to Roosevelt, and then Carcillo made a beeline off the bench in the middle of a legal change. And the linesman and referees did a good job of getting in between. There's the hit by Roosevelt, high hit, penalty was coming. And then Jackman. And now Carcillo's going to get a penalty as well, looks like.
Well, they're trying to defuse the situation. Steve Ott telling the linesman, Andy McKelman, he came off the bench, but as Eddie pointed out, it was a legal line change. And there he goes. Defuse the situation.
And they weren't scoring a lot of goals, and that was the one that they had early in the season.
That's a strong shot by Steve. Once again, it's walked on by Steen. Oh, she threw it in front. Oh, and back is McGreevy. He tries, and he can't get it by Ronta.
Steve Rook and Backus. We've seen that before.
It's in front of the net. The end of this play, Backus drops his gloves and takes a swing at Seabrook. I'm not sure if he connects or not.
It was close.
Good job there by the officials.
4 points of the top two teams, Nashville and St. Louis, who will battle tomorrow night. Laid onto the back now for Cole's drive. It's saved by Ronta. He saved the rebound from Laterra. Chicago Blackhawks. It was close for a while, but it ends decisively at 4-1.
A couple of early power plays knocking that first period for the Blues when the game had no score. And that number one penalty killing unit for the Chicago Blackhawks did the job early to give their team an opportunity to gain some traction.
The 289th consecutive sellout in Chicago, 21,514. Watched and appreciated a lot of what that man was able to do tonight in Antti Raanta. The final score in the game, Blackhawks 4, Blues 1. For Bernie Federko, for Grant Mulvey, who once had 5 goals and 2 assists in a Blackhawks game against the Blues. For Pierre and Eddie, Mike Emmerich saying good night from St. Louis. Stay tuned for overtime.